In this tutorial, I'll show you how to validate a form in Spring MVC. We have a form and here we have username, age and password. So we'll see how we can validate. If username is not entered, it is giving this error. Then age may not be null and the password must not be blank. Password must be between 1 to 10 character. So to create a form, we need a form class. So form class has username, age and password variables, and we are using the Hibernate validator framework for validating the inputs, not empty, then number format and number format style. So these are required, and not empty we have used here, then size. Here we have specified the minimum and maximum size for the validation of username field, and this is integer type, and the validation is not null, number format minimum 1 and the maximum 110. So the private, and finally we have password field which is not empty, and minimum length is 1 and maximum is 10, and then setters and getters. After this we need the controller class. So controller class is handling the / validation form.html request. In get we are simply creating the instance of validation form and putting it to the model, and in case of post it is validating. So if the results has errors, return the validation form. So that is this validation form.jsp, and if there is no error we can simply display the validation success. So this is validation success, which is displaying simply the username. Apart from this we need the dispatcher servlet, which is defined here, and it is picking the views from webinf/views. So webinf/views folder, there should be an entry for dispatcher servlet here, servlet, and then the servlet mapping. So to create a validation form, you need the form class with the validation criteria specified as annotation, then validation controller, then the form.jsp file. So form.jsp file is posting the data to validation form.html, and the command name is validation form. Here we have username field. So here we have errors, form errors. So this tag displays the form errors on the screen in the red color, and this is for username, this is for the age, this is for password. Actual input form is form.input, form colon input username, form colon input age, and form colon input, and form colon password password. So to run the application, you can either create a var file from here, port as a var file, and then deploy on the Tomcat. And if you have already have a embedded server here in the Eclipse, you can run it here, run as, run on server, next, and finish. Now this is running. Click on validation form. Form is here. I don't enter anything, so it gives error. Write something. So this conversion is not successful. Finally displayed the successful. Deepak saved successfully. So this way you can create the form in Spring MVC and then validate. We have thousands of tutorials on our Spring framework on our website. Visit our website and learn from these tutorials. Thanks for watching the video and subscribe our channel.